How do we identify our own biases?
Well, the first thing that you can do is answer the questions in chapter 2 of the book, and you will have you can create your own cultural profile. Where you have strong tendencies, it asks you you create levels for your tendencies. And are you, let's see, you said you were situation oriented. Well, you might be moderately situation oriented. There are people who make it almost a point not to obey rules. My husband, interestingly, is moderately situation oriented. I didn't even know he was situation oriented for years, because situation oriented people obey the laws that they think are reasonable. Hmm. So my husband stops at red lights. He thinks that makes sense. There are countries where people don't stop at red lights, you know, if there's nobody sure. coming the other way, right?
Right.
So he has moderate tendencies. And when he fills out the chart, he shows up as moderately situation oriented. If he were extremely situation oriented, what that would tell us is that he would be somewhat inflexible about rule following.
I see.
He would find it difficult to work in a highly rule-oriented environment. So wherever you have strong tendencies, you are less likely to have flexibility. And that means that someone who's highly oriented in the opposite direction, highly rule-oriented, you might find annoying. So did you ever have a fifth grade teacher who stuck to the rules and you rolled your eyes a lot? Well, that's that reaction, that's that cultural reaction to somebody who's got the opposite tendency. So by doing the cultural profile, you can identify your own bias, what you prefer. You can also recognize areas where you're going to have more or less resistance to the opposite tendency. If you're right in the middle, all the way down, you're what I call a cultural chameleon. People who have multi-ethnic families sometimes are that way. They're used to both sides of the continuum because their mother is one way and their father is another way, or they've grown up in a very multi-ethnic environment where there are lots of different tendencies operating at the same time. Mm. And they've kind of learned to go with whatever's happening. Mm. And those people are, they are sort of cultural geniuses, and they just pick up on what other people are doing very quickly and modify their approach to be appropriate. And sometimes they don't even know they're doing it. Most of us have a strong tendency here and there. And those are the ones that we have to look out for if we're operating in the opposite kind of environment or with people who have opposite tendencies.
Do you see that as being highly empathetic as well?
Yes, I think that cultural work creates a much more empathetic approach, because once you understand that the person opposite you is operating according to what they've been taught all their lives to do, mm-hmm. and that they're not trying to drive you crazy, but rather this is how they've been taught to approach this task, and it's different from your way, but in their environment, it works better. One of the things that it's really important for us to realize is that going into a new environment, the things that we're used to doing aren't necessarily going to work. And we tend to think of our own approach as best. Mm-hmm. So our schedule-oriented people tend to think that they are sort of superior because they stick to the schedule and they know what they're supposed to be doing and they do everything on time. Mm-hmm. Well, if you think that in many emerging economies, the bus leaves when it's full, right?
Wow, yeah.
So what happens to a schedule-oriented person in a situation like that? Wow. They go crazy. That's... They can't count on anything.
Yeah.
There's no benefit to being schedule-oriented.
Right.
What you need in that environment is to have a plan B and a plan C and maybe a plan D, because things are not going to happen as planned, right?
Wow.
And so in that environment, people don't take schedules very seriously. They have different ways of accomplishing their goals. It's not because they're bad. It's not because they're lazy. It's because they have a different set of tools.
Right. When you mentioned someone like Brazil, would Brazil be something like that? But it depends where in Brazil.
It does depend where in Brazil. So Brazil overall is extremely flow oriented. That's the opposite of schedule oriented. But I work with teams of Brazilians who come from São Paulo, which is a much more schedule-oriented city than other parts of Brazil. So if you're working with them, you don't have that tension if you're schedule-oriented. Working with people from they call themselves Paulistas, and so it's important to know who you're working with, and again, not to overgeneralize. The way that I explain cultural tendencies is that they are like equipment for a game. So if you went to a basketball game holding a baseball bat, and said, hey, I'm ready to play, and everyone looked at you, what would they think? Well, now that's a ridiculous scenario, right? You wouldn't hold hold a baseball bat up at a basketball game. And yet, when an executive starts, you use the outsourcing example, when you begin to manage a team of people who are overseas, you are, in essence, holding a baseball bat at a basketball game.
Fascinating.
Because the managerial tools, the process tools, and other things that you have are probably not going to be appropriate to that situation. Mm. But you won't know that. You won't realize that, and you're going to have to learn it probably the hard way. So the benefit of having a systematic approach, my book shows you what to look for, how to recognize those tendencies, and then to understand what they mean, and then how to manage them.
One thing that I found really fascinating was you mentioned predicting problems, and that could be hugely beneficial. How can we predict problems?
Well, if I'm very schedule-oriented and you're very flow-oriented, then I'm probably operating in an environment like the U.S. where schedules are very, very important. If you're flow-oriented, not only do you not perhaps have deadlines as the same level of priority that I do, but also you may have a lot of things in your environment that make it difficult. Maybe you have, during the monsoon season, the road washes out and you can't get to work, or the electricity goes out. You may have, the bridge may not, may be down, may not open and close or go up and down on the day that you need to get to work. So in your environment, not only do you not prioritize schedules and deadlines the same way, but you may also have impediments to getting things done. It would be really good for me to know that about you. Mm-hmm. So we could work things in. For example, there could be incentives for early or on-time delivery. There could be penalties in our contract for you to deliver late. In ways to remind you and to motivate you to really make sure that you honor those deadlines that I consider important, that you don't naturally consider important in your own environment.